Making pizza at home is so easy. Let's get our oven on at 425 preheating. I've got some all-purpose flour here. I've got my baking powder. I've got my salt. So let's mix all this together. This pizza dough is a little bit unique. We're not using a yeast. It's so fast and easy that the kids can actually make their own dough. So while you're making yours, they can make theirs too. So that's how easy it is. So now we've added our water. We're gonna add our olive oil. We wanna incorporate all those ingredients just with a fork. It's time to get our hands in there. So at this point, we're gonna take a little bit of flour, dust our working area, and I'm just going to cut it in half. Just knead it. And it's time to start forming our pizza. Put our flour on a rolling pin, and then we're gonna just start stretching it out. And every time we roll it, as you can see, I'm just spinning the dough. So important when you're using a rolling pin that you don't go off the edge, because what happens is you're gonna start flattening the ends of the dough. The kids can make their mini versions. And instead of just putting it on a pizza pan, they can put it on a baking sheet, you know, make three or four little mini ones and put the garnishes that they like. So at this point, I'm just gonna reach over, put a little bit of olive oil on my pan. I'm gonna fold that, put it on there, and then fold that out. At this point, I'm just going to just keep working it, get those edges down. It's a homemade pizza. It has to look nice and rustic. It doesn't need to be perfect. We're just gonna crimp the edges a little bit. And there we are. So what I'm gonna do now, just wipe off my counter because it's important to actually work very clean. And we're gonna start off with our pizza sauce. I'm just gonna start right in the middle and then just swirl the back of my spoon. I'm not gonna hit the edges because I don't want them to burn. If we put sauce on the edges, it'll burn. This is a ready-made sauce, but if you'd like to make your own sauce, it's incredibly easy. Tomatoes, tomato paste, a little bit of oregano, garlic, and you're ready to go. Now it's time to add our garnishes. So let's start with a little bit of pepperoni. And this is where it's fun and it becomes very individual. If you want to do something a little bit more gourmet, you could add mascarpone, you can put Swiss chard on here, arugula, whatever you'd like. A little bit of pesto works too. Now I'm gonna take a little bit of our mozzarella cheese, and then, of course, one of my favorite garnishes, mushrooms. A little bit of green pepper, red onion, which gives it a nice pop and good flavor. I'm gonna finish with a little bit of cheese on top. I always find that keeps all the garnishes together and it melts and you got that great bubbling going on. We want to take a little bit of olive oil and just brush the edges. Just lightly, and that's gonna give us a nice crispy texture. Put in the oven, bottom rack for about 10 to 15 minutes, and you have homemade pizza for the whole family.